We are friends, digging each other, taking time to talk it over.
Welcome to the Lion's Den.
Oops, I did it again. Got something, ding. I don't know the word.
With Detective Jason, welcome to the Lion's Den. Make sure to rate, review, subscribe.
Our producer just walked out on us.
You're dealing with two ADD people. I can't focus if you're
moving. That's why I gave you a thumbs up before I left. I was like, keep going.
Oh, yeah. But you have to understand, we have ADD. We just looked at your thumb. Hey, thanks for coming. Thumb!
Oh, okay. My bad.
I just thought, good job, Brent. Keep going. And then you got up and left.
Oh.
Like a bad dad at Little League. Good job, son.
Good job, son.
Dad?
Trevor,
I'm
going to
go
up.
Drink in the car. Good swing, son. I'm going to go call my girlfriend.
I never fucking loved you.
Dad, my helmet's too big, you fucking little bitch.
Welcome.
Ahead, Jay.
What episode are we on? 47?
47.
Episode 47 of the Lion's Den. Welcome back. Please continue to rate and review at Apple Podcasts. Give us a 5-star rating and give us a crazy, funny, weird, fucking cute, lovely review, and we'll read it. And as always, subscribe at YouTube and hit that notification bell.
Bing!
So you know what's coming at ya. It's my Britney voice.
I know.
And as always, the Lion's Den, what is it? Patreon.com/theLion'sDenPod for all your members only content. Will, do we have a review?
I'm trying to find an old one we never read. So yeah, give me a second.
You've changed.
Will's kind of dropping the ball on producing.
You've changed, dude.
I don't know what's going on. You've changed, dude.
I want to mention something while he waits for the review, though. Because you're doing some Britney voices. Your conspiracy theory.
I did it again.
All right, I got one.
Actually, wow.
Thank you.
That was good.
Here's one real quick. This is from back in May. This is from CM Cook. I absolutely love this podcast. These guys are hilarious, and I love watching how the topics devolve into an amazing slew of insults to Will and voices from Brent and Jason. Please come to Royal Oak, Michigan for a live show.
Absolutely.
So, I'd love to.
Thanks, CM Cook. Good podcast. I'm doing podcast.
CM
Cook.
Sounds like you're saying Sam with a accent. Oh, yeah.
Sam Cook.
Hi, Sam.
All right. So for people that usually listen to this show, this is Sunday Brunch for Monday. It comes out Monday. But today, while we're filming this, because of obvious complications, our episode came out where Detective Jason was breaking down Britney Spears.
Yep.
And we've been getting a lot of emails. And yeah. Jay comes back over and goes, I got something else for you.
Oh, yeah. I found this new thing that there's a... One of her videos on her Instagram, she's dancing around with a hat. If you could pull that up.
The Instagram up.
If you pull up Britney's Instagram and you scroll down a bit, there's a video of her doing her little cute Britney stuff. And she's holding onto a white hat. But the way she's holding the hat, she's got her finger pointing.
It looks like she's
pointing at something and she keeps putting it. And it's so obvious that she's like, look at my hat. Look at my hat. Look at me hat. Whatever, however she talks. Look at my hat. I guarantee she does not talk like that. She probably talks like this. You guys, I'm fine. I'm not this girl.
Where is it? Did they take it down?
No, it's
how far is it?
Oh, it's keep going, baby. You'll see it. She's holding onto a white hat, and the way she's holding
right
it, that one. And see where her finger's pointing?
Oh, it is on the... Oh, it's perfect. So here's the video.
That is a message.
Look at this.
If you flip that upside down, what does it say?
People
are saying that it says help.
So she's pointing to something.
She's holding onto her white hat. Her index finger is pointing to something written on the hat. And a lot of people said it says think that it says help. That's wild.
I'm gonna try to flip it.
I'm still kind of on the fence with all this stuff, but like this kind of shit.
This kind of, because when you did that whole deep dive, I was just thinking you're like Sherlock now.
Yeah.
You're like Columbo. But when you showed me and Will this before we did this podcast, I went, oh, shit, maybe. Yep.
So here's kind of a more zoomed in version. By the way, watch on YouTube.
It's hard to see.
Watch on YouTube also. It's hard to see.
But it is something.
It's something.
But it's
something written.
A lot of people think it's H-E-L-P, which
it looks
spells
like four
kids.
Words or four
help
letters.
This could be
anything, though.
Yeah, but also, think about this. No, because she's pointing at it. And it is written out. It's not like
it does look like when you're not zoomed in on it, because when you zoom in on it, it gets all pixelated and weird.
Yeah.
But when you're not zoomed, it looks like she's definitely pointing at something.
She's
written
pointing
on her
at
hat.
Something, and that kind of hat, it wouldn't be dirty. So you
right.
have to assume it's something that's written
and
she's pointing at.
That would
at.
Be specifically dirty.
Also,
yeah, I mean, look, I mean,
play the video. It's a nothing video. What song is that?
Wow, shit, yeah, and she keeps pointing at it. Oh my god.
And then she's saving herself by making it just this.
Well, you nailed the Britney impression when you did the dancing.
I did a bad, bad thing. See the song? They did a bad, bad thing. What?
Wow.
This is really fucking creepy.
And what is her caption?
This is how my niece plays with me. Peekaboo. Now you see me, now you don't.
Now, if she's talking about how her little niece is playing cute with her, why is she playing that song? They did a bad, bad thing. And who's the they? I'll tell you who the they are. People in charge of that conservatorship. Pops, whoever else is in charge, lawyers. That's crazy, right?
Yeah.
That definitely looks like somebody wrote on the hat.
We're already getting shit for your language, your love language.
Oh, yeah, yeah. My
then
love language.
My somebody sent to you?
Like if I'm...
Do you have that photo?
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Somebody messaged, oh my God, you did it twice. So does that mean Brent's holding you captive?
Because Brittany did the same thing that he was improvising.
Oh, yeah. So wait, do you want me to pull up that picture? Did you send me that?
Oh, I did. I sent. Okay, yeah.
Is that what we're talking about? Sorry.
Yeah, that's what I was.
My little thing I said on the last episode where I'm like, this is going to be our symbol when I'm captured or whatever. I'm fucking, because I'm not done with the Brittany stuff. So I'm looking around at shit and I just kind of pulled up some videos of her, and I found this video of her doing that, and I just thought it was so funny.
I didn't care.
It must have not gone through yet. Email, you know.
Felt dead weight. But Detective Jason is back at it again because he discovered something on Wayfair.
Drop it to my laptop. Sorry. I had to.
It's okay.
I'm going to airdrop it to you.
Crack every knuckle in your body. That was the loudest thing I ever heard. I actually think you broke your hand by accident.
I'm just playing it really cool. I'm in so much pain. There we go. That was way easier. Technology.
Now you'll see. She's doing my.
Oh wait, you gotta. Oh, we're good. Okay.
She's doing my move. To let me know that. Letting you know. There it is. What was the noise I made?
I mean, this is hilarious.
I'm going to be honest. I have never seen that picture. So I don't want people to think that I was copying
that. No.
I saw this today.
This is my favorite thing.
After I made the kind of joke about if I'm ever held prisoner by a conservatorship that Brent had the courts put on me.
We gotta do a side
by
side.
The point of you even doing that is if you're gonna do language, like you want to let people know, but you can't.
Right,
it has to be aggressive. So the comedy is going like help.
But yeah, man, I'm telling you, I want people to email us about this. This is so interesting to
Detective
me.
Jason, dude.
I want to do a side by side.
This is so interesting to me. Idiots.
No, Jesus. Why are you making us watch us?
Because I'm.
This is the most narcissistic moment of this podcast.
Look,
he's doing something.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, don't worry about me.
I know what he's gonna do right now. He's...
Oh, just keep talking. Just keep doing your thing.
But yeah, keep.
hold on.
If you can watch,
hold on.
If people can see what he's doing right now.
Yo, if you're not watching this on YouTube, you're...
You know what, dude? You're part of the conspiracy now.
I mean, look at this dude. Dude, if you can get all three of us doing it, holy!
Oh yeah,
look at.
I'm like, what the fuck? You brought me into this,
you
dude. We're going down. The FBI is taking us.
Hold on.
We're part of it now.
Oh my god,
we're part of the problem.
That's fucking.
Look at this. Are you kidding me?
Oh my god.
Oh shit.
I want to free her. I want to save her.
Oh, dude,
this is. The craziest moment of the line set so far. I'm just seeing this fucking thing. Is
honestly, Your Honor,
seen.
I was just yes-anding my friend. And I didn't mean to be involved in the Britney goddamn conspiracy.
Dude, what are the chances of
fucking, I know.
Of all the things
so
to do?
Weird.
Fuck.
Brett, you did start it with it. Did you
know
something?
No, he started it.
You started
it.
You were like, I'm going to do this.
No, he did it first.
Brett,
what? Your Honor, watch the video.
There's no
you
way
did.
I
watch.
You,
watch.
You
I did? Shit.
Hold on. Let me close this.
And then I did it after you.
Watch.
Like an idiot.
Fuck.
Watch.
All right. Well, Your Honor.
Boom.
I'll wear Nikes.
Wait, you got to hold on. We got to listen. Hold on.
I don't know.
Move your sign.
I'll wear Nikes.
Also,
yeah. Well,
I would be this.
Like a lion.
Oh, shit. What's being All right. Listen, Your Honor.
Everybody's like,
oh, man, it's real.
Jason's was funnier.
It's real.
Oh, fuck.
So, Brent, do you know something?
Do you know? Yeah, dude, what's up?
What's up, man?
Whatever, guys.
I wonder why you thought of doing that.
Well, because
and then we did it, and now
I can't, dude. I'm my. That's like, so I'm fucking nervous. Weird.
That is. I only was because it's a lion's den. So ears.
Is that a lion?
Oh my god.
That's where I was coming from. I was either thinking of that, or I was thinking of Jurassic Park when Newman gets eaten by that fucking weird lizard.
Don't spoil it.
Yeah.
Don't spoil it.
Wow. And I was just thinking, like, if I was gonna get out of something and I couldn't say anything, it'd have to be. Yeah. I didn't know she did it, too. We're part of the problem now.
We are. We did
it. Fuck. Hold good. I don't really like that no one is, when I tried to spread that rumor that people thought I was an arms dealer. No one's written me about that yet.
Yet.
I really want that. What is that?
Oh, nothing, dude.
Well, that's not that subtle.
No, goddamn it.
Our listeners, I'm not wrote keeping out help on his notes showing
oh,
us.
Shit. You can joke around, but that's a really good impression.
There you.
I know.
But that's crazy because she doesn't really sing like that. She that sings like this. And you, and you, and you, you're gonna love me. That's how she sings.
Unbelievable.
Even in bits, you're just killing. You
I know. It's annoying.
Really annoying.
But yeah, you got another Detective Jason got Wayfair.
We gotta have a theme song for Detective.
I went into another rabbit hole, not as deep. But I just started hearing about this Wayfair, you know, the online furniture company or whatever.
Yeah, because we mentioned I got a bunch of this shit from Wayfair.
Don't tell,
and Overstock.
Don't, no.
I mean, Overstock.
He didn't.
I got it
Overstock.
From Overstock.
Got Overstock. It Overstock.
Jesus. Brother.
Apparently, people think that Wayfair is a front for sex.
Oh, Detective Chase.
Sex trafficking. Yeah.
Really?
Yeah. And there's this whole conspiracy about them, and you can see videos. People are TikTok, dude. TikTok is gonna get fucking canceled. They're gonna get themselves shut down if they're not careful. They're bringing out all these conspiracy theories, and one of them is this fucking Wayfair thing. And basically, if you go on Wayfair's website and like look up, there's a certain like cabinet. There's a certain cabinet, and there was. This cabinet was listed for $100 or whatever the fuck it is, but it was on there twice. And the second time the cabinet was on there, it had a name. You know, like IKEA names their shit weird.
Yeah. Or Gorschlobs.
Yeah, yeah. Gorschlagen is apparently a fucking duvet.
And you got to go there and be like, where's your Dorschlobs?
Duvet cabinet.
And then you stop and eat meatballs at a cafe for some goddamn reason.
Where's those
Which
schlobbers?
We've all done, by the way. It's brilliant.
I know. But
those hot dogs.
They are naming their products after females, like women names, like weird names too. Like if you Google it, Google like Wayfair trafficking conspiracy and then hit videos.
I'll just say conspiracy. If
anything. You know? No, trafficking?
That's a word I can't spell. By the way, conspiracy
well, trafficking.
You nailed trafficking.
Did I get it right? Nice, I got it.
And if you go to videos, maybe you'll see... But like they're you go on and you look at certain products and they're named after a girl. They have a woman's name, and then the price is like $15,000 for this thing. Yeah.
Do you want me to find that video we were looking at before or no?
Yeah, that girl knew what's up. But like we don't need to show her whole thing. But
yeah,
I just
first thing when you tap on YouTube Wayfair, the first thing is trafficking.
That's
then
crazy.
It's review bed escandalo.
Go to trafficking.
And then trafico.
Trafico.
Like kind of a cute.
It's
way.
Not a laughing matter.
Whoa,
sorry.
What's Ellen doing in it?
Uh-oh.
Ellen allegedly involved in Wayfair conspiracy.
See what I'm saying?
Oh, here we go.
Oh fuck.
I'm gonna look this shit up.
So where do we wanna start here? Should we just this is from BBC? I
mean, there's another real quick though, there's another video where there's a pillow on there that you could personalize your name.
What did I say? Pillow?
It's a pillow.
Well, what is that one though? The BBC one.
Yeah, I mean
since that's news. Is that about trafficking?
I bet you they're saying it's bullshit.
Yeah, I would click that one as opposed
false
to some...
conspiracy.
Yeah.
That's what they say.
Live TV.
Wow. Sit through a fucking ad.
But there's this pillow that you could buy on there that you could personalize your name on it. And the pillow itself is like $49.99. But as soon as you type in like the name Ashley, it goes up to like $11,000.
And then they, well, some of the specific names, it was like Samaya. And then they Googled the
And then they, yes. Yeah. Like really odd names like Samaya or Yaritza or some shit. And they Google those names and they're missing girls.
Wow.
That's the craziest part.
They're missing girls. You know? one of them, that name Yaritza, I think it was, that was like weird because it's very specific name. That's what they named the cabinet. That's when the cabinet turned into a $15,000 cabinet. And then that's the name of a girl who's been missing since like May.
Crazy.
And apparently, since people have been pointing it out on TikTok and YouTube or whatever, they took that shit down. You can't go on a website. Wayfair's website isn't doing that anymore. Like, people were going on thinking it was a glitch, but then going, wait a minute, that's a very specific name, very specific glitch.
Is it still happening?
I don't know.
We should check.
Maybe we should check.
Why don't we check that?
That's what I was wondering when the BBC News was going to say. This guy. Well, the now it's
furniture company. Have you seen this? The company in question is American. It's called Wayfair. As you Wayfair. Can see, it sells furniture and home goods. But home it's recently good. Had to deny it's part of a child trafficking ring.
There it is.
All of this is originating from the QAnon community.
There's that shit too, QAnon.
First of all, here's the theory. A lot of these storage cabinets on the Wayfair website have girls' names. A well-known QAnon activist noticed this and tweeted, "My spidey senses are tingling. What's with these storage cabinets? Extremely high prices, all listed with girls' name."
Now that they're saying QAnon's pointing it out, it just makes it not legit.
I don't know what that is.
Illegitimate.
Whatever. A rapper.
Go to the Law and Order.
It's not to me. I don't think it's legitimate now because that QAnon. I don't know if you know what QAnon is. QAnon is this. God, it's so fucking hard to explain. Dude, Google QAnon. It's really hard for me to explain with my dumb brain.
My dumb brain doesn't know how to spell it.
Yeah, I don't know how to spell Q. The letter Q, and then listening. Anon.
Anon.
What's Anon? A-O-N or A-N?
Whatever. What is A-N-O-N? QAnon. Wikipedia. Bam. What does it say?
QAnon is a far-right conspiracy theory detailing a supposed secret plot by an alleged deep state against U.S. President Donald Trump and his supporters.
Yeah.
Oh, Jesus.
Basically, it's all like 4chan.
QAnon is the one.
That's the dark web.
Yeah, 4chan is the dark web.
Yeah,
QAnon,
that's what the dark web is. You
guys have heard of Pizzagate?
Yes.
They're the first ones to point that shit out, Pizzagate. Basically, it was a place called Cosmic Pizza or Atomic Pizza or something like that in the D.C. area. And they were saying that Hillary Clinton and all these other Democrats were involved in a child trafficking ring that was running out of the basement of this pizza parlor. But the one thing that the pizza parlors lacking as far as evidence is a basement. I guess they went in there and it doesn't have a basement.
This immediately nullifies it. Well, there's no basement.
Right.
Oh, have a basement.
Let's wrap it up, boys.
Crazy. Yeah.
Saying 4chan is dark web?
Yeah.
Google dark web. I want to get there. Maybe we can get you that monkey. I can get that panda.
Dude, I want a monkey.
Dark web.
How to get to the dark web. Wink, wink. Type that in.
It says wink, wink?
Well, you got to do that for
the
internet.
How to get on the dark web.
On the dark web.
The second one is how to get rid of double chin. And then how to get taller.
See?
Actually,
they're listening. They're listening. God damn it.
Seriously, how to get taller. Give me that.
Steve, not Steve Carell, but Steve, the other one. The other one that has a late night show.
Ow.
Oh, Colbert?
Stephen Colbert.
Steve?
Stephen. Stephen. Is it Steve Carell or Stephen Carell?
Steve.
It's Steve Carell and Stephen Colbert. I actually didn't even Colbert, process they have the same first name.
Yeah, he talked about this on his show, and he even pointed out the fact that they went and investigated, and the place doesn't even have a basement. But people believe this shit so much that a guy actually showed up to the pizza place with a gun.
And he's just
thinking that he was going to save the fucking kids. It's just Bruce Willis? Bro, it's just a pizza place.
Wow.
It's just a pizza place.
Imagine being the pizza place. What can I get you? Give me the kids. The basement.
We don't have a basement, sir.
Listen, we're just a simple family here. We don't have a basement. We don't have a basement. Beverly, get downstairs.
Yeah.
And down where?
And this QAnon apparently makes all this shit up to and says that Donald Trump is the savior to all this stuff. He's going to be the one that ends it all and saves us all from this.
He's going
to
save us all?
Yeah. Basically it's in support of him. And people got really sucked into this QAnon thing. I remember I heard a story of one lady who got really fucking into it and was just sold. And then they started, then she realized they're a religious group. They start posting like Bible verses and shit like that. And they're like, wait.
The QAnon?
Yeah. Q was a person that just started tweeting. It was in October of 18 or something, they tweeted this really cryptic tweet that said it's fucking, and then now, and then Donald Trump, this fucking idiot, he retweets tweets that are supported by QAnon, and then says things like, you know, fucking, you guys better get ready, it's coming, like set, like really subliminal shit like this. And there's pictures of him pointing at a baby that has a Q on its shirt. There's pictures of him making a symbol for Q. It's fucking weird, man.
It's fucking crazy.
All that shit is so goddamn weird. And guess what? It never existed before the internet.
Yeah.
No. Yeah.
The internet is scary. Well, some fucking of that stuff world,
was
man.
Just hit. It was just hidden.
Yeah.
I think I mentioned to you, I'm reading this book about JFK and how like all the shit that no one knew about, like all the conspiracies. Yeah. And it was just like, he was just sleeping with prostitutes in the White House every day.
Oh,
and just no one really knew, and it was never discussed.
Keep it down.
Well, listen, he was a good man.
Here's the thing.
It's a Brookline boy.
Here's the thing. Back then, there was a thing back then that doesn't exist anymore called privacy.
Yeah.
They literally were, you only saw them in the spotlight. Once they were done waving at the cameras, not only did we not know what the fuck they were doing behind closed doors, a lot of people didn't give a shit.
No.
It's like old Hollywood.
Yeah.
The only thing people knew about their favorite celebrity is the movies that they did and the interviews that they did.
Yep.
Now we have to see them
sitting
at a coffee shop with a gut.
Yeah, it's every photo is literally this.
Every photo, walking their dog with a kid in their arm, looking at the camera like,
oh God, yeah.
You know, not now, man. Yeah. I'm living my life.
Ugh.
And the internet created that, man. It
sucks.
It's trippy, but this fucking Wayfair thing might be.
It might be true, but the other thing too is that, just to piggyback off what you're saying, is people seem to forget that we're all human, so shit happens.
Yep.
Like, just because you could see it is one thing. Like, when I was doing a tour, and I never get to stay at nice places, but I'm in Boston, and I'm staying at this 5-star hotel. It's when I was doing Undateable Bill Lawrence, and he couldn't stay in anything that wasn't rich.
Right.
So we stayed at this hotel. I didn't even know what it was. I called my best friend, Elliot, who lived out there. He goes, oh, that's the Kennedy Hotel.
Oh.
I go, what does that mean? And the woman that was giving us the tour of the hotel, because it's like super fancy, like straight out of fucking Home Alone 2, you know, like that type of place.
The Waldorf.
And they go, and this is famously known as the Kennedy Hotel, because this is where the Kennedys used to sleep with their mistresses. So if we go down this, I go, that's part of the tour.
Wait.
that was part of the tour.
Also, I don't think they want you to be telling everybody.
Yeah, I go, what kind of tour is that?
Jeez. Are you looking at the pillows?
I'm on Wayfair trying to customize a pillow. To see
By the way, I completely just customized California, New England. With saying
it's got to be a name. It's got to be where you could punch in your.
I know. I typed in custom pillows.
Yep, it's not.
Only 300,000 results.
Also, what I've heard with this conspiracy theory is that once people started pointing it out online, Wayfair disabled it and took it down, and
I assume.
I'm not being insensitive with this, but could you search pillow prostitutes?
I don't know if I want that on my computer.
If we're gonna...
Will's going to get a girlfriend one day. And she's going to go through his...
I know. I'm just trying to...
And all he's going to have to do is go, it's Lion's Den, babe. It's Lion's Den.
Brittany, hat problems, sabotage, Law and Order. Law and Order, pillow prostitutes, black web,
dark web,
how to get taller.
Oh, man.
Double chins.
I can get you a drop.
I'm gonna
get a drop board.
Like, I'm gonna keep looking this shit up, man.
What was the cabinet thing? What was that?
The cabinet on Wayfair?
The thing that was like $12,000?
Well, no, it was like a regular cabinet.
What was it called?
It's a cabinet, like a two-door cabinet. Are you gonna?
Well, I want us to find that.
Yeah,
but I mean, there's so many cabinets. How about Wayfair has everything?
Oh, yeah, right.
With thousands.
After
thousands.
This,
I'm not. By the way, I don't want this to start coming off as an advertisement for Wayfair.
Yeah, I know. You gotta pay us first. I mean, but also if you're doing the thing that's been told, we're not in. But
yeah, look at that.
I mean, no but there. But
I'll do price high to low. Let's see if it's any. What's the most expensive cabinet?
$35,000.
Yeah, I mean seriously, that's what we in that video we watched. No, $6,000.
Jesus.
Type in Lion's Den chairs. I want to know if I got the chairs from here or overstocked.
You think it's gonna show up as Lion's Den?
Well, maybe.
Chairs?
Maybe we're already popular. Maybe
that'd be cool. Wishful thinking.
Lion's Den chairs.
Come on.
If shit comes up, what?
Fuck.
It's a good lamp. Look at this lamp. Why don't we get this lamp?
It's a nice
lamp. Good lion
lamp,
huh?
How much?
$170.
Completely backfired on me.
I'm not going to support this company. This
no.
Brent, until I know for sure
Brent,
this shit ain't real.
After we leave.
Yeah, that's shit.
Oh, man. I'm going to look this shit
up. That's actually a beautiful painting. but I don't support this until I know what's going on.
That there's not little kids locked in the cabinets.
Because I mean, when I order that painting, it doesn't mean I want like 19 little kids running around my house, you know? I just want the painting. Is it that hard in this society?
The cabinet shows up, the doors are going, the fuck? I ordered a cabinet, not children. Jesus, no wonder it was 13 grand.
Oh, fuck.
Fuck. All right, well.
I want to say this one thing.
If you know anything about the way.
Yes, please.
Email us.
No, contact the police.
Us first, though.
We'll go. Detective Jason first.
We want the exclusive. We want the exclusive.
We are the police.
Yeah, we need the exclusive, to be honest. But we also care, but we need the exclusive.
We care so hard.
But Free Britney and Wayfair, we need it. So give it to us. We'll exploit it, and then we'll help. I do want to mention this one thing, though, because people always ask about the squirrels, and they ask about the bees, and the bees are gone, and the squirrels are still fat, and they're eating, and they're doing a good job. But now I have a black widow problem.
Yeah.
And I left a nest. I found a nest yesterday, and I've left it so that we could kill it together for the vlog. Okay. So get on Patreon so you can see it.
We're going to do that?
Yeah. And
you ever seen black widow eggs?
They look like little cotton balls. I saw them.
Well, you'll see them today.
I didn't know that's what they were until you said that's what they were. Mm-hmm. And then yesterday I go, oh, that's what's around my trash can.
And they're poisonous, right? Black widows?
They can kill you.
Yeah.
Great. Perfect.
Mm-hmm.
Really great. Hey, Brett, move.
Honestly, yesterday one of the eggs fell.
Ooh.
I know. And that's the thing. With the bees, I could deal with. Squirrels running through my house sounding like elves, I can deal with. Spiders.
Squirrels running through my house, running through my house.
But yesterday, one of the eggs broke open, and my buddy Matt Gagne was here, Black Hat Motorworks, shout out. And he goes, oh, look, they're right there. And there was three little spiders, and he would go, and it jumped, and then...
Smart spiders.
At the end, he goes... all the way up to here, and he goes, well, I think they're in the house now. So
never sleeping again.
Might be some black widows in here. So that's the new problem.
The thing is, I don't think black widows want to be around us. But
they have an arrogance.
They're very... I mean, first of all, yeah. That venom can kill people.
It's crazy.
That's
an attitude.
Unnecessary. Unnecessary. All right.
You just have a bunch of Scarlett Johansson's running around. This is actually not a bad problem.
Oh, yeah, she's Black Widow. Look at that. They have like mark. Why is that guy holding it? Yeah, that mark on their belly.
Is that?
Yeah.
Oh, that's what it looks like?
Yeah.
Good to know, by the way, if you ever see a Black Widow.
Yeah, the mom had that.
The female, right?
Yeah.
Females have that, yeah.
Me and a spider.
Could have been you.
Yeah, could have been.
What's in that balloon ass of his, you know? Damn, that's. Yo.
Ew.
That Black Widow's got a donkey on her, huh?
Oh, God.
Get a donk on that widow.
It's nice that they have a clear
baby
thing.
Got back.
It's nice to know that they have a
clear. I can't wait till the day you guys show up and it's clear, like Stephen King book. I'm going to be sitting here like this. And you go, Brent, and then it's going
across your face.
And I'm just, my eyes are dead and there's a spider coming out of my mouth.
The noise you made. The fact that person's holding it. What?
Oh,
what is that giant
thing? That's fake.
Giant black widow bite?
I don't know. I'm sorry. Well, Jay, what I was trying to say is that the marking, they have a clear marking, so you know it's a black widow. Yeah. The orange thing with the big ass.
Yeah.
So.
Look at this fucking.
Is it orange or red?
I'm getting out of here. I'm done.
Is it orange or red?
I don't. We're going to say orange. Ew. Okay. Ew. Icky.
Oof. Let me ask you a question. Be honest. Be dead honest. When you walk through a spider web, what is your reaction? Because, can I give you mine?
Yeah.
This is me if I walk through a spider web.
Oh, yeah.
Immediate panic.
I look like a drunk white aunt at a wedding dancing after her fifth drink.
Isn't it so weird when you're by yourself, though? And how many times you're doing
always.
That?
Yeah, always. Doing always. It's in my mouth.
We never do this until spiders are on us. What is happening here at the web? Oh shit. And you're by yourself when it happens, just and then you do this with your fingers and then
I'm a rat.
Yeah, I actually got already. Yeah, let's move on.
God damn, I'm itchy.
Let's do emails. And don't you get mad immediately? Like, don't fucking trick me with webs at my face. Keep it by my knees
where it should be, not at my fucking head.
Like a tripwire. Make your webs a tripwire. It's the worst, dude. Like a crazy person.
And then you'd be watching TV like an hour after, still going.
And then you bump your knee.
Brent, we're gonna take you to the home. What happened to him?
Bring my Sour Patch Kids.
Black Widow's web. It was by my face. We know, Brent. Should have been at my knees.
Oh, it's in my nose. It's in my nose.
Oh, it's actually grossing me out.
God damn.
All right. Reminder that it's podthelionsden@gmail.com. It's on our Instagram if you want to email us. Brent, your mic's out. Follow us on Instagram, by the way.
Is it in now?
Yeah. Brian, I'm trying to have sex, and it's
I don't like that he's getting quick.
It's at the Lion's Den Pod is our Instagram. Okay. Just a reminder. All right, so let's switch. Is this your?
Is that Bugsy?
It's a live feed.
My package came. That's my Ring doorbell. UPS guy just set it down.
Bugsy ain't having it.
Is that Gorilla Bat or is it Jack?
That's Gorilla Bat.
Oh shit!
Gorilla Bat, right? It sounds
kind of Gorilla Bat.
Straight up, bat.
I think that's the thing. Gorilla. Oh, the nice
Jack
sweet
barks
one?
Like a dog.
Yeah.
Bugsy does this weird scream.
Yeah.
It's like Jesus, you don't even have nuts anymore. It sounds like somebody's kicking your nuts.
You know what I remember about Jack back in the day when we did stand up years ago, when stand up existed. Every time he would, remember when he would bark so much that he would fall off the chair?
Yes.
He would bark the
window. Oh, okay. So whenever you would pull up to my house, Jack would jump up on the chair to see you through the window pulling up in the driveway. Yeah, and he does this thing with his head. When he barks, he doesn't just go, rawr, rawr. He goes, rawr. He like throws his head back. Jack throws his head back when he barks. And he would bark at us when we pulled up and he would go, rawr, rawr, and like throw his head back till he fell.
He literally knocked himself out, and you wouldn't see him for like a second. Then he'd go back up, going rah, rah. I just always remember that. That was back in bowling alley days.
That was Jack who did that.
Jack, yeah.
Hilarious.
Dang it! I want to call Kyle, neighbor Kyle.
Call him.
Tell him to bring my shoes.
It's about a package.
Yeah.
See if this is the first live phone call in the Lion's Den.
No, we called my mom once.
Oh, we did. You're right.
Yeah.
Second call.
We're still waiting for Jen.
Oh, yeah, Jens.
Jens.
Oh, he's not going to answer.
To think he could have been on the Lion's Den.
Mm-hmm. Kyle, damn you. Hey, you're on. Hey, Kyle, you're on the Lion's Den right now.
What's going on, guys?
Are you home?
No, I'm actually out of the state.
Damn it! I just got a package delivered to my front porch, and I wanted to see if you'd grab it for me.
I can have somebody grab it for you.
All right, cool. You said you're out of state?
Yeah. We're visiting Sheeta's family in Nevada.
Just so you guys know, his fiance's name is Sheeta, and he's not visiting a family of cheetahs. I know it sounded like that, but that's not what's happening. But dude, yeah, if somebody could, I just got my Ring doorbell thingy saying that my new shoes came. Thanks, bud.
All right, guys, have a good night. Have a good show.
Later. So funny. Yeah.
All right, we can switch gears here and do a fatty habit.
Switch gears here. I love that.
Thanks. It's
like a bad late night host going, okay, when shit gets like way too racist.
When you have bad host.
We're going to switch gears here. And we're going to.
Either a really bad host or a boring host.
Yeah.
Okay, why don't we switch gears and go to phone calls.
So Mary Cardenas told us about a fatty habit idea, and then we replied to her saying, "What's the name of this app?" Because it was something about an app.
Yeah,
and it's called MyFitnessPal, by the way.
I have that. That's what I use.
It's tracking your calories and workouts and shit. Yeah.
Annoying app I have now that goes, "You didn't put in today."
Yeah,
and I go, "Because I'm eating pizza."
It should
alone
come on. It should have this notification.
Fatty. Yeah. That actually would work better for me if it goes
piggy
fat
piggy fat piggy. Boy.
You little pig boy fatty. Bitch. Like, whoa.
Whoa.
You can customize it.
Well, what is it called? Wellness?
My Fitness Pal.
My Fitness Pal.
Got it.
This one's from Devlin the Dick Umpire.
Cool.
Haven't heard from him in a while. Hey, guys. First off, I absolutely love the fan interaction you guys do on every episode, actually reading emails and reviews. Thanks, dude. Okay, so.
It's our thing.
To the fat kid cravings, I have the absolute guilty pleasure of Taco Bell. Obviously, one of the most garbage fast food places for your body, but I'm sorry, I can absolutely destroy food there. My order is five soft tacos, chicken cheese quesadilla, an ungodly amount of sauce, and cinnamon twists with a large Mountain Dew to wash it down.
Oh, you gotta get that.
Even after I get this and devour it alone in my truck, sad, in the parking lot, because you obviously cannot be seen doing that in the restaurant.
100%. Or by your family.
Or family or friends. You gotta, that's one of those.
When I eat in the car, I'm hiding.
Yeah. Because you obviously cannot be seen doing that in the quote restaurant. And also Corona right now. This still doesn't always feel filling. I don't know what that means. The only downside I have to craving is the disaster that follows later in the day from eating too much Taco Bell.
Oh, I know. Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
I get it. I had Taco Bell yesterday.
The explosion down under? That's what he's talking about, right? Yep. Is that what you're talking about?
And also, I really appreciate Hershey's honesty.
Yeah, we love the honesty.
Like the fatty habit fake ones where they go, I had two protein bars. No, be honest with us. Because we've
Taco
all been
Bell's
there.
That. Let me tell you mine. Ready?
Yep.
Two combo burritos. And two soft taco supremes.
There you go.
What's a combo burrito? What's?
Let me tell you. It's a combination of a bean burrito and a doobie doobie doo. It's a combination of a bean burrito and a beef burrito, but it's also, I'm sorry, no. I used to do the combo burritos. Then I graduated. I do two burrito supremes and two soft taco supremes. Here's what's in the supreme. You get beef and beans and sour cream. And I always want my burrito con creme because it's so good. Yep, pretty much.
You know, mine is at Taco Bell. Two chicken quesadillas, cheesy gordita crunch.
Oh, god damn you.
Bean and rice burrito.
Ooh.
And one Dorito hard taco.
Oh, those, yeah.
And that's, by the way, in one sitting.
Can I do a confession right now?
Confession time.
Which 3 days ago.
Okay.
What's his name?
Devlin.
I ate it in my car because I was ashamed of myself.
Mm-hmm.
I love the honesty.
Preach.
I drove through KFC.
There you go. What'd you get?
Oh, boy. I got the leg and thigh meal.
Mm.
What were my two sides, you ask?
Oh, mac and cheese and mashed potatoes.
Right? No, mac and cheese and mac and cheese.
There you go. There you go.
Doubled up on the mac and cheese. I was having a day.
Hey.
And I wanted to feel better.
It's a stress
through KFC.
Food.
And I say, give me some of this bad for me. Original or crispy? Original, bitch. Original's so good.
Mm-hmm.
Original spicy. It has a little spice to it. I didn't know this, and I was so happy. Then it came with this, because you don't ask for it. It comes with a biscuit.
Oh, yeah.
And now a chocolate chip cookie.
What?
Yeah.
They added a cookie.
Mm-hmm.
Didn't know that.
How shitty I am. What would you like to drink? Oh, I'm going to be healthy and have an iced tea. Yeah, let me get KFC iced tea unsweetened because I'm watching my figure.
Well, since you're being honest, I'll be honest. Mm-hmm. Yesterday, I went to Taco Bell.
Did
and
you?
I actually got something that's new. It's called the grilled cheese burrito. It's called the grilled cheese burrito.
Is there a grilled cheese sandwich instead of a
tortilla?
I think
something similar to Chipotle, a quesarito, where they take a quesadilla.
This is just like, I happen to be by the Taco Bell. So I pulled in. And it just had, I never heard of it, but it was, you know, they have the little photos. They do the best art
for the photos. Photos are good.
And it just said grilled cheese had me at that. So I went, let me get two of those. And I had two quesadillas. And so since you were honest, I'm being honest.
Oh, KFC three nights ago, alone in the car.
I was alone in the lion's den with no cameras doing this.
Sad. Sad piggy.
And then ever so often I'll do this.
Imagine walking in on Brent.
Oh.
And he's just rappers everywhere. Yeah. I have had a bad day.
You could argue that it's sad or it's like the best life. Because I'm single and alone and being able to eat and no one's judging me.
That is a
Taco Bell and KFC, man. Those two, the weakness. When I get a fast food Jones, I'll do like El Pollo Loco because they fire grill it. It's chicken and you can get the veggies on the side and it's But man, when I want to be a piece of shit, Taco Bell.
Yeah, Taco Bell does.
I've done this. Gone through the drive-thru and went, you know what? That's not enough food. And gone through the drive-thru again.
Way.
Yeah. I was a big boy back in the day.
FJ.
Mm-hmm. Hey, man.
FJ.
Work in excess and we live in excess. It's just what it is.
I don't think I've had Taco Bell in over 15 years.
You know what I used to have?
It'll make
Shit.
Yeah, I'm good.
Enjoy.
No.
All right.
Taco Bell. Taco Bell and Panda Express.
That
Panda.
I fuck with.
They love to make a second appearance later that night.
Oh, yeah.
Hey, we're back. We're down here now.
I never had Taco Bell until I moved to California. I never had Mexican food until I moved to California.
Taco Bell, I think, is a California thing. I think they started everywhere now, but it started in California.
What they had where I grew up was a Taco Bell / Pizza Hut
drive-thru.
The 90s. Personal pizzas.
Mm-hmm. So 90s when they started doing the Mega Mix.
Target has them. Yeah. Where you can get the personal cheese pizza or the pepperoni pizza with the breadsticks.
Combo.
And the fucking, I would do like a Mountain Dew, of course. Oh, that was my thing.
And then you're just in Target.
Yeah.
Yeah, I know it's not. It's weird, but.
Walmart's used to have, or I don't know if they still do, McDonald's in the fucking lobby of the Walmart. That's so how it should be, actually.
I actually think, yeah, I would have to say the Pizza Hut drive-thru window or Taco Bell is my, like, when I just go, fuck it.
You ever start talking when you know you're gonna throw up? You guys,
When was the last time you threw up, Jason?
Oh, it's been a long time.
I feel like neither of you throw up very much.
I throw up all the time.
Actually, no, you did. Yeah, you did the meat incident. Remember when I was over?
Yeah,
and then I left, and you were like, "Good thing you didn't eat that meat."
Yeah, I don't. Yeah.
I haven't thrown up in a long time.
I had food poisoning.
I'm one of those that's terrified of it.
Oh, me, yeah. I get it.
No.
Yeah.
No.
Do that impression again.
Guy who's scared of throwing up is gonna.
You know. Oh, no. And then you have Taco Bell, and it's coming out of both ends.
Yeah.
Anyways, thanks for the email.
Thanks, Devlin.
Jesus, that guy's living his worst life. Oh, there's shit.
Your body
everywhere.
Does the weirdest shit when you throw up too. You just this dry hunch just
when I throw up, I'm always over the toilet and I think like of like Ray or like the behind the music things because you're always going
Yeah. Like always blood. Just Oh God.
Yeah, and then you do this. Spiders.
Part of me's glad I'm throwing up because I know I'm gonna lose weight.
Yeah, that's where I come from. It's like a
sneeze. My pants are gonna fit so much better.
I almost gave Will food poisoning in the beginning of the quarantine
because
I left the red meat out and I was trying to make this steak bolognese.
No,
he didn't eat it.
My theory, it's because the theory. You can continue. I'll go after. Go. I don't know.
I ate it, and then the whole night I was going,
"Oh no!"
And then I hit him up, man. I can't. Something happened. What was your theory?
Because my thing is, I don't usually eat food from people who they cook when they cook it. There's very few people I want to eat food when they cook it because I don't trust anyone really. Generally, deeper issues. But and you were like, because I was like, I'm gonna go eat. I'm gonna go eat, and you're like, I'll make food here. And then you made the shit. Come on, you made it for me, thinking I was going to eat it, and I was like, "Nah, I'm good. I don't really want to eat it." And then he fucking texted me, "Dude, good thing you didn't eat that. I'm throwing up."
Yeah, I left it out too long. I like cooking,
and I trust you.
It had a good idea,
but yeah, it was like, but it was nice for me because my theory was like, that was exactly what my fear happened. It was exactly why
it's annoying. Then I don't like feeding into his fears.
Me neither. By the way, me either.
So he just justified.
I'm a good cook, just so you know. I cook shit right.
Oh, I know.
I just get nervous with that stuff. That's all. And it was just like that was like now I'm never gonna eat it from anybody.
That was a really.
I made myself a steak for dinner last night. Steak.
Really.
Steak and steamed veggies. Mm. But I grilled it on my barbecue.
Oh yeah.
Oh, so fucking good. Little medium rare going.
Oh yeah.
I'm trying to get in.
Little bitch was bleeding. You know what I'm saying. All right. Next email.
We're gonna cut that out. No, I'm just kidding. This is from Caitlin Miles.
Hi, Caitlin.
Dear Brent, Jason, and Will, this is going to be a good one. It's no joke when people say you sound like three friends sitting around talking. You really remind me of my friends, friends I'm missing a lot right now because of quarantine. So besides the fact that you three are hilarious and fun to listen to, hearing, I was laughing at him, that was so subtle, and fun to listen to, hearing you three talk is comforting. Anytime one of you likes one of my tweets about the podcast, reposts my Instagram stories, or likes/replies to my Instagram DMs, it really brightens my day.
Oh, nice.
And in parentheses, she said, I'm the one who tweeted about feeling the anxiety during the episode where Jason and Brent put Will on the spot and tried to make him sing. here's why I'm writing. Tonight, while catching up on the podcast, I created a Lion's Den bingo card that my best friend and I may or may not use. Just while we listen to the podcast or watch it on YouTube, but more likely, number two, as a drinking game while we listening or watching the podcast. I've attached a sample card. Let me know what you guys think.
Bad boy up.
The rest of it says, you guys are great. I've been a fan of Brent for a while, and Loki have a crush on him. But now also love Jason and Will. Do people / adults still say crush? # Corona crush. Maybe I'm saying in my feelings over Brent is better because # Drake. Right, Will? But really, thanks for everything you do and stay safe. Caitlin. Great email. All right, so here's the Lion's Den bingo card. This is the thing I can see is just sad in all caps. Yeah. All right, so let's go. We're gonna go like top to bottom here. So we have Smooth Bully.
Okay.
You guys want to read it or don't want me to read it?
You do it.
Then we have Brent and Jason do a bit on the spot.
Yeah.
And then we do. All right, this is a mess.
Jason gets dead, man.
So location mentioned by name, like San Diego or Long Beach. Brent or Will get mad. Questionable clothing / making fun of an outfit.
Ooh.
Jason gets dad mad. Play on words related to coronavirus. Someone, by the way, these are bingo squares. Someone can't remember something. And then sad in all caps. Brent mentions relationships girls are being horny. someone struggles to say a name or flubs in general.
Yep.
Weird / funny / heartwarming story sent by listener. And this is then in the free space. And then comedy venue mentioned by name. Rate, review, subscribe, Patreon. Will is unsure / shocked / confused. Growing up stories, lion, I don't know what that is, and then hey guys, Jason does a bit or a voice. Oh, so you're wasted by minute five. funny one-liner / quip by Will. Oh, nice. Brent does a bit or a voice. I mean, you're hospital. One guy makes the other two laugh really hard. Singing. Well. And then something related to Brent's house. Squirrels, bees, planes.
We just mentioned Black Widows.
I mean, only this one that's was missing, so funny.
Only one that's missing, you got all caps sad. There should be an all caps point being.
Oh, you're right. Yeah, okay. Yeah. We'll post this on the Instagram.
I actually want to.
So funny.
When they're done, I want to frame that and put that in.
Yeah,
here,
that's fucking
actually
awesome.
Really awesome.
Yeah.
It's Caleb, like a little yearbook.
If you play it as a drinking game,
don't die.
Please videotape it.
Be careful, number one. Be safe. Careful.
Fuck that.
Number
have
two,
fun.
Videotape.
And also, talk to me about it so we can work it out. So it shouldn't be a shot
that's
a
so
fucking
funny.
Thing.
Yeah.
Because
you'll die.
You got to figure it out with like a beer and maybe something
like
else.
A sip.
Yeah, right. We could talk. Maybe I'll play with you guys.
Yeah.
We should do, actually, I'm bringing this up. We didn't discuss this. We should do a full, at some point, live Zoom with fans podcast. You know, that'd be kind of fun.
I love that.
That could be that's a Patreon.
No idea how to set that up, but
it's within. We can do it within Patreon.
Oh, that'd be cool.
Let's do that. So if you join Patreon, we can do a live.
You can come on the podcast live with us.
Yep.
That'd be kind of
Patreonics.
Cool.
Only the Patreonics.
Yep. So I'm for Patreon.
Hold that out of my ass.
Yeah. All
right. Cool.
Oh, thanks, Caitlin.
Thanks,
Caitlin.
That's awesome. I love the bingo shit. All right. Let's do.
Yeah, that kind of made me like sentimental. I like that.
I don't know if we have.
I like Brent talking relationships, horny or alone.
So that was so long.
I know. I've been saving it because it's so long. Do we want to go for it or save it?
Well, where are we at on time?
We have about 10 minutes left.
That's a 15-minute email.
Yeah, maybe we save it.
Let me hear it.
All right, let's see. What, this is from Connor. Connor L.
Connor, when did he send this to us?
End of June.
Let's read it for him.
So he needs advice on a friend. So he needs help. We need to help.
Friend's already dead. Yeah, we waited too long.
Sorry.
All right, I'm going to skip to the point. So Connor, I mean, so dick. Will, it's pronounced the same way as all the other spellings. Yeah, man, Connor's easy. What am I like? Conair is writing in.
Conair?
Yeah, Conair. Oh, it's better. Fuck.
Yeah.
All right. I've had a friend for a very long time that throughout the years has given me a lot of problems. We have known each other since kindergarten, but it seems every year we have a falling out that just ends it up resolving itself. It's a very rocky friendship. Recently was our latest falling out. We are in an Instagram group chat where we send memes amongst our friend group. One day, one of our friends sent a dumb meme, and in response, he said that he was making a new rule in which if you send something cringe, we will vote on it, and you could get him kicked out of the group chat. It seemed like he was joking. I responded that this is ridiculous and he can't just make up rules by himself. He responded by kicking me from the chat. No vote, by the way. I then DM'd him and said jokingly that I hate him. Also, not joking a bit. Oh, not joking a bit. So he's not really kidding. And I also asked to get back in the chat. He said, I don't know. You said you hate me. I then complained to one of our friends privately and said something along the lines that he needed a punch in the face. The next day, I noticed that the friend who kicked me out had blocked me. I then called the friend I had complained to and discussed this with him. This friend told me the situation wouldn't get resolved unless I apologized. For what? So since I was blocked on everything, my friend sent an apology to the other friend acting as if it was from me. Later, my friend who helped me told me that the friend who kicked me said that he needed to think about it. The pettiness is getting hard to handle. Stuff like this has been going on for years. He once didn't talk to me, and coincidentally, the friend who helped me for an entire summer because we said that his dream of being a commercial space flight company owner and stock market guru was a bit far-fetched. Yo, this is starting to piss me off how long this is. So with that, I ask this. What do I do? Do I stay his friend and deal with the pettiness?
No.
Or do I keep my distance? Yeah. He's a larger member of the friend group, so if I distance myself from him, it might cause a rift in the group, and I don't want to do that. What do you guys think?
Here, first of all, let me start. Remember when we were talking about a few episodes ago how cool it is when girls have boy names? This is obviously that situation. Connor's a girl.
I was actually
Connor's a chick, obviously, and so are all the other people named boy names chicks. I mean, what are you guys doing? First of all, the guy is obviously the guy that's the friend that's trying to be a dick. Obviously a control freak.
Yeah,
he's obviously extremely painfully insecure about things. And if he's got it out for you, young lady, Connor, he's definitely jealous of you. You're probably hotter than him. Probably have bigger tit. I'm just kidding.
I was literally going to say, well, first off, are you a bunch of fucking girls?
Wow.
Like, what is this shit?
I have never in my life ever had anything like this with my guy friend.
I honestly almost wanted to bail halfway through that. I was like, this is so ridiculous.
But also, let's be fair to Connor. First off, Connor, the fact that you wrote an email this long-winded about this shit, obviously, it's regardless of that one meme, you have a problem with this guy. So obviously, it doesn't work out. Just say fuck
it. His concern is the guy's... he said he's a more important, bigger friend in the group.
Well, he's
if he loses that one, he might lose the group.
He's a large member.
Is this guy a fucking cult leader?
I don't know.
A large member? Is that...
He's big.
Oh, he kicked me out of the group and he blocked me. I'm like, all right, man. I broke my best friend's collarbone
the next
day I was over
here. Here's my advice.
Yeah. There you go.
He's probably young, obviously young because of this email.
Yeah.
Hey, Connor, get better friends.
Yeah, fuck him.
Or get better friend, that guy.
Fuck
this guy.
Yeah, fuck that guy.
But if the other guys are going to follow him later...
Then fuck them too.
Yeah, find a new friend group.
I mean, who blocks anybody?
Yeah, that's so
bitch.
Jesus
Christ, it's so bitch.
Yeah.
Blocks.
Nah.
Christ,
I'll tell you what, Connor. I'm joking aside. I'm sorry for shitting on you for the long email. Follow up. Let us know what happened.
Yeah,
I'm invested.
Let us know how you and the rest of your girlfriends are doing. And we'd love
honestly,
to hear.
My like best friend shared a crib with him. The things we've done to each other are some of them are illegal.
The thing that the guy got mad about wasn't that big a deal.
No,
Connor, tell your friend to fucking grow a pair.
And honestly, if you were still in the group, we could tell you definitely Smooth Bully over here could give you some good comebacks. We're in like multiple comedian group chats.
I mean, if we got mad at that kind of petty shit,
oh my God,
we'd have no friends.
It would never work.
What a trip.
And also, you have the funniest people in the world that all fuck with each other in one group. If somebody leaves the group, remember when people leave the group, you just add them back.
We bring them back in. You ain't going anywhere.
You ain't going anywhere.
You ain't going anywhere, Jack. All right, well, that was okay.
That was good. Well, Connor,
Thank you, sweetheart. Thank you, young lady.
We can do one more. You want to do one more?
Sure.
Or save. So funny. Sorry for walking in the frame.
Young lady. Fuck, I feel bad though. We can't be.
I know.
This is from Angie Miguez.
I love Angie.
Living
ride
that
ride or die.
Living, yeah, she's a ride or die. Living that yacht rock life.
Mm-hmm.
Super excited to see the. Hey, you delicious waffle stack of a group.
Nice.
Super excited to see the humidor turned out great. Should we shout out the humidor?
Angie Miguez, it's her.
Popping it up. Gonna put it on.
Yeah,
the
she
old...
gave us a cigar humidor.
Look at that.
So awesome.
And I got the AC fixed. And if I'm not killed by spiders, we'll get some fucking cigars for it next app.
Boom.
I'm going to be dead.
I hope it's helpful and gets great use in the den. I'm curious when you have to drop a bit or a joke. Example, did Brent no longer use the ones shown of his on his specials?
That's on
special.
You, dude, not her.
Yeah, they were seen... We're going to start this over. Action. Did Brent no longer use the ones shown on his special since they were seen by the entire world? And Jason, and for Jason and Will, do you replace older jokes and you create new ones? Or do you just realize, oh, I guess that, I guess I no longer do that bit. Also, it, when do you call back? There's a lot of questions. Also, well, let's stop there. Let's
Well, pause. First of all, Brent can answer the Netflix thing.
The second it's done, it's done.
Yeah, you burn the material.
Yeah, we burn it, and then it's for you, and then we rewrite.
And for all of us, I believe that we're always, the way we do stand-up, we're always trying to evolve the set. The set's ever-evolving.
Mm-hmm.
And you run out of room. There's very, very few places that you could do a fucking four-hour set. So you have to kind of keep everything within an hour to an hour and 20.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, I feel like you're always getting better the more you do. We suck now because we haven't had to be able to do stand-up for 4 months.
I can't imagine what it would be
like. Oh, we're terrible now. I don't even think I'm a stand-up comedian.
I don't either.
What is stand-up comedy?
I forget.
But, yeah, you're always... For me, the set is always ever-evolving.
Mm-hmm.
Because, I'm not going to say names, but we have people that we know that we've seen... We've been seeing them doing the same set for the past 15 years and it hasn't changed.
20.
And you look at that and you're like, how are they not... fucking
miserable,
losing their mind, you know, saying the same shit over and over again. For me, it's always ever evolving, and you know, stuff gets dated, and you know, like I can't talk about stuff about my kids when they are teenagers. They're not teenagers anymore, you know. I could talk about it as a past thing maybe, but like, yeah, I like keeping it pretty current.
Yeah, it's the same. We do the same thing, but also on the road too. Like when me and Jay are doing shows together, we're constantly, it gets down to like of instead of a and this, and you know what I mean?
Right.
It becomes so nitpicky that there's a certain point where you kind of want to just throw it out there because you're never going to stop changing. And it becomes like an obsession.
Yeah.
Like you're Howard Hughes with the fucking long fingernails pissing in jars. That's what jokes become to you when you keep doing them, where you start going, God damn it, just put it out there. Because here's the deal. During quarantine, I've never watched any of my specials ever. I've never seen, unless I'm in the edit, once the edit's done, I've never seen anything I've done. And I went and watched them. Oh my God, it was depressing. I literally was going, slow down, yelling at the TV and just
watching yourself
you
so
hard.
You
fucking loser.
Like, for you, I mean.
More.
For me, I'm like, God damn, this guy's a genius.
I know. You fucking nail it from this to that. Something happens to me once I get on camera. I'm like, what up? And I go, fucking loser, bitch. Like, I hated it.
What about your older? You ever watch, like, your Laugh Factory clips? Like, all those videos? Or either of you guys? Both of you guys have a bunch of those.
No.
It's come up on suggested stuff, so I looked at it. Sometimes it's harder for me to look at the old ones because I feel like a fatty.
You were a fat guy.
Thank you. And, yeah, I just look terrible, but. The bits were great. I'm a genius.
Actually, you still didn't look terrible. You look good, but you're so much thinner now. It's kind of nice to see that.
Thank you.
Sometimes I see things and I go, Jesus, what happened?
It's honestly hard to watch myself.
Yeah. But yeah, we burn, like most comics, Jerry Seinfeld argues against this though. He feels that an audience wants to see some greatest hits.
They do.
Where Louis and those guys say, well, I think if they come to see that and if you don't give them something new, they won't come back again.
Right.
And
I think with music, it's more about how awful. David Spade had a bit about it where he would, don't you hate it when you go see your favorite band and they play one of their hits and then they go, all right, now we're going to play some of the new stuff. And you're like, ah, fuck.
Yeah.
You want to hear the shit that brought you there. With comedy, I think it's a little different. They want to hear comedians get a lot of, you did the same jokes again, you know?
Well, comedy's funny when it's unexpected.
Right.
So when you're expecting it, it's not funny.
Right.
And it's super fucking hard.
Good questions. And thank you again for the humidor. We love it.
Yeah, seriously. Thanks, Andrew.
And we're going to fill it.
Cool.
That was a great episode.
We did it.
Fucking
and we're not sweating, see?
That's so nice.
Nice, right?
So nice.
Yeah, this has been
AC's
great.
Fixed.
Yeah.
This has been amazing.
No, God damn it.
So we will see you next time at the Lion's Den.
We are friends, digging each other.